About 300 miles, approximately 500 kilometers, off the coast of Oregon, United States, lies one of the planet's most intriguing geological regions, the Axial Seamount. This underwater volcano, hidden nearly 1 mile, about 1,600 meters, beneath the surface of the Pacific Ocean, is part of the infamous Pacific Ring of Fire, a zone marked by intense seismic and volcanic activity that encircles the ocean. The American West Coast, particularly the Pacific Northwest, is home to several active volcanoes such as Mount St. Helens, Mount Hood, and Mount Rainier. Though submerged, Axial is considered the most active volcano in the region and has attracted scientific interest for decades. Since its recorded eruption in 2015, Axial has become a natural laboratory for geologists and oceanographers. That year, the volcano was responsible for an astonishing swarm of up to 2,000 earthquakes in a single day. It caused the seafloor to sink by around 8 feet, about 2.5 meters. Since then, multiple monitoring stations have been installed in the area, including measurement cables and state-of-the-art sensors, allowing real-time observation of ground movements. In recent days, researchers have raised the alarm once again. The submarine volcano has been shaken by over 300 earthquakes in just 24 hours, an activity considered highly unusual and concerning. Professor William Wilcock, an oceanography expert at the University of Washington, stated, "If this volcano were on land and people lived nearby, we would have already started evacuations." His statement underscores the seriousness of the situation and the need for constant vigilance. This series of tremors may be a clear sign that magma is rising. It moves through cracks and fissures in the oceanic crust, forcing its way upward until it finds an exit, potentially resulting in a new submarine eruption. The good news is that, unlike in past years, there are now underwater cameras and sensors operating continuously, making it possible to record this eruption in unprecedented detail. Axial is a volcano of gigantic proportions. Its structure resembles the size of a city, stretching across miles, several kilometers of ocean floor. Its depth prevents tremors from being felt by coastal populations, but its internal activity plays a major role in studies on volcanic behavior and eruptive cycles. So far, the earthquakes have registered low magnitudes, typically between 1 and 2, but within a volcanic context, these are extremely significant. The current scenario raises many questions. Are we at the beginning of another eruptive sequence like that of 2015? At that time, the number of earthquakes gradually increased, reaching astonishing peaks of thousands per day just before the eruption. While current activity is smaller in comparison, it follows a similar acceleration pattern, prompting scientists to remain on high alert. One of the main challenges in predicting Axial's behavior lies in its erratic nature. Unlike other eruptions where magma rises steadily and predictably, this volcano has shown irregular patterns. There have been moments of rapid inflation followed by complete stagnation. This inconsistency makes forecasting a potential eruption even more difficult for experts. In addition, there is the issue of the volcano's inflation. In 2015, the structure rose approximately 2 feet, about 60 centimeters, per year. Today, the rate is slower, around 8 inches, approximately 20 centimeters, annually, but it still represents ongoing pressure within the magma chamber. This chamber, located about half a mile, 800 meters, below the seafloor, acts as a large reservoir of molten rock that, when inflating, generates the tremors detected in the region. If magma continues to rise and pressure reaches a critical point, the oceanic crust could give way, triggering a new eruption. The direct impact on human populations is unlikely due to the area's isolation, but the geological effects and scientific knowledge gained would be valuable for understanding other active volcanoes in the region. That's why the scientific community remains on high alert, closely observing every movement of the Axial Seamount. As seismic activity increases, scientists are paying close attention to any new signs of internal movement at the Axial Seamount. What stands out most right now isn't just the number of earthquakes, but also the signs of inflation, the slow swelling of the volcano's structure caused by magma accumulation. This process is similar to a balloon being filled to its limit. When there's no more room for magma in the chamber, pressure can lead to a rupture and trigger an eruption. In its last recorded eruption, Axial released lava that formed layers up to 450 feet, around 140 meters, thick. This type of flow is known as pillow lava, which solidifies quickly upon contact with the ocean's cold water, forming rounded structures that resemble cushions. Beyond their impressive geological formation, These events were responsible for around 8,000 earthquakes and significant subsidence of the ocean floor. Unlike other volcanoes, Axial can release lava not only through its main crater, but also through dikes, lateral fissures that channel magma in unexpected directions. This type of eruption, similar to those observed in Iceland, can open new vents far from the volcano's center, increasing the complexity of monitoring and making predictions even more challenging. Despite the current level of activity, experts assure that there's no immediate danger to coastal populations. Axial's remote location ensures a significant safety margin, even in the event of an explosive eruption. What stands out, however, is the scientific potential of this event. Observing a submarine eruption in real time, with sensors and cameras actively recording, could provide unprecedented data on how these underwater processes unfold. This renewed activity has also sparked interest in other regional volcanoes, especially those located on land near densely populated areas. Mount Rainier, for instance, lies about 240 miles, roughly 380 kilometers, from Axial, and has shown seismic activity in recent months. Unlike Axial, Rainier poses a direct threat to thousands of people, particularly due to lahars, volcanic mudflows that can travel at high speeds and great distances, even without an eruption. Lahars are one of the greatest concerns for experts monitoring Mount Rainier. If material is suddenly released, cities like Tacoma, Olympia, and even parts of Seattle could be affected. Local authorities already conduct evacuation drills with residents based on detailed risk maps outlining the most vulnerable areas. The knowledge gained from monitoring Axial may prove essential in anticipating similar events in other Pacific Northwest volcanoes. Besides Rainier, the region's volcanic chain includes well-known names such as Mount St. Helens, famous for its devastating eruption in 1980, as well as Mount Adams, Mount Baker, and Mount Hood in Oregon. All are part of the extensive Cascade Range, which is geologically connected to the Pacific Ring of Fire. Their collective behavior is closely linked to the subduction of the Pacific Plate beneath the North American Plate. If you found this content interesting and want to keep learning about the Earth's hidden forces, don't forget to subscribe to the channel, leave a like, and share it with others. Your engagement is crucial for us to keep bringing high-quality, insightful, and reliable content your way.